I'm Carla Littleton, the Animal Inhabitants Coordinator here at the Carnegie Science Center. And because we need to continue providing care for our animal ambassadors, I'm here at the Science Center today. However, I'm practicing social distancing. There's no one else here with me. I am the only staff member here. Being that you can't come here and visit with us, I want to talk to you some about our animal ambassadors. Today I'd like to talk about the difference between frogs and toads. We have the American toad, which is a very common species here in Pennsylvania. This is a female. We can see her chin here is white. If this were a male, her chin would be dark colored. But we can see a lot of the characteristics of a toad. We have the bumpy, dry skin. Also, her legs are short and very muscular. Even her back legs are very short and muscular. It's because a toad is made for digging instead of swimming. The toes are not webbed. They're long and skinny. This makes her good for digging and burrowing. They'll use their back legs here for digging. The other thing that's different between a frog and a toad is if we look here behind her eyes, there are these lumps. These lumps are called parotid glands. They're a poison gland. Now, for most frogs and toads, this is not dangerous to humans. These glands will excrete a toxin that for the animals that eat them, such as birds and small mammals, will make them sick. The other thing is we can see she has a nice, clear white belly here. That clean white belly tells us she's very healthy. She's nice and pudgy. The other thing we'll see is her eyes, and this is common for frogs and toads. If they close, they actually go down in her head. She does not possess true eyelids like we have. Instead, their eyes actually go down into their skull, which is kind of interesting. And that's true for a lot of amphibians, no eyelids. So we'll take her and compare her to a frog. We're gonna work with our gray tree frogs today, another species that's common to Pennsylvania. They're a little wiggly. Compared to our toad, they're much more active. This is a sign of a tree frog. They can actually hold on. They have very sticky feet. We can see very smooth skin, smooth and shiny skin. Long muscular legs for jumping. We can see he doesn't have that sort of pudgy body shape. He's long and skinny. And that's a sign of us having a frog instead of a toad. The other big thing with most frogs is that most frogs will stay in and near the water. And that's one of the differences between a regular frog and a tree frog. The tree frog will stay in a tree and only come down to the water when necessary or for breeding. That's sort of a little different than most frogs. Most frogs are going to be in and near the water. A toad can actually live out in the forest and only come to the water to drink. So that's a big difference between our frogs and toads. So there he goes. And again, that's the tree frog. He can actually hold on to me. If you remember with the toad actually couldn't hold on. We can see he has these pads on his toes that allow him to stick. The ends of the toes are swollen here. So that's a little bit of difference between a frog and a toad, and the difference between a tree frog and a typical frog.